You know what it is like to long Let's pray. O Spirit, who helps us in our struggles and teaches us how to pray when we do not know what to say or how to feel, we call on you from a sigh too deep for words. Within that sigh, we wonder, we question, and we hope that all things do indeed work together for your good. And in this experience of being here together, in this time set apart to be side by side in community, we are reminded how connected we already are. Let us open ourselves to your presence here. Let us seek first the kingdom of God, and in our searching, may we be found by you, beloved, the one who searches for us first. Amen. Please join me in a responsive reading of Psalm 119, printed in your bulletin. Your decrees are wonderful, therefore my soul keeps them. With open mouth I pant because I long for your commandments.
Return to me, and be gracious to me, and answer your questions with those who love your name.
Keep my steps steady according to your promise, and never let iniquity have dominion over me.
Redeem me from human transgression, that I may keep your commandments.
Make your face shine upon your servant, and teach me your statutes.
My eyes shall set your ways in the earth.
I invite you to share with one another your prayers of joy, concerns, and any news with one another.
Well, you know, sometimes we want to just have just all the joy that life offers us all the time. We want to be in that state of mind, but sometimes that's not the situation for some people. The unexpected happens. And even though these weren't friends of mine, I knew them, but a close friend of mine is suffering. Because his wife of 43 years old just passed away from ovarian cancer. And she was a lovely young lady, very lovely. And she left behind two young children. One was 14 and the other 6 years old. So the whole group is in a really tough situation right now. And her name was Teresa Peacock. And her husband's name is Sean. And my friend's name is John. And so they're all in tough shape. So please remember them in your prayers. Thank you.
Sean, Teresa, Sean, and John.
And John.
I'd like to invite you to stay after worship for some refreshments if you're able. Let us pray. Our loving Creator God, you shape us in your image. You call us to humbly serve others. You call us so we might be hope to a world loaded on despair and fear. You are our shelter from the storm. You give us nourishment for of your good creation, your earth. We pray for our church in these days. Help us not to be afraid of the future and of those around us. Help us to remember to plant the seeds of the good news of your love. May we always be Christ-like in our lives and be a source of light and love for all who need you. We give thanks for the wonderful diversity that exists in our country and around the world. We ask for those who must make decisions on our behalf, be wise and discerning, and choose right paths so that all the people may be served. Eternal God, throughout the centuries, you have called people into service and have equipped them with gifts for using and sharing in the kingdom's cause. We give thanks for their faithful service, and we remember in particular those who sowed the seeds of faith in us. Keep our faith strong and enliven our witness that the Church of Jesus may prosper and that many will know the love of God from which nothing can separate us, your love. And we pray the prayer that Jesus taught us, and an uprightness of heart toward you. And you have kept for him this great steadfast love and have given him a son to sit on his throne today. And now, O God, my God, you have made your servant king in place of my father David. Although I am only a little child, I do not know how to go out or come in. And your servant is in the midst of people whom you have chosen, a great people so numerous they cannot be numbered or counted. Give your servant, therefore, an understanding mind. moral evil. a hidden treasure in a field, a valuable pearl, a fishing net. All amazingly vivid ways to talk about God's presence in the world. Strength, mystery, unexpectedness, beauty, delight, joy, practicality, simplicity. These are some of the traits of the realm of God. Instead of focusing on what we think we know about God, we are invited to be in the presence of God, hear the voice of God, feel the presence of God in our lives, to be received, to be loved. The gospel, which means the good news, is for friend and foe, marginalized and privileged, oppressed and oppressor, and everyone in between. Jesus helps us to be free from empire thinking and systems of evil that create barriers, dismantles bridges, separates the beloved of God into enemy camps. And so Jesus invites us into the kind of relationship with God where God's loving action in our lives is recognized and celebrated. And so I invite you this week to reflect on the places, the ways in which God is present in your lives, to recognize God's presence, the yeast in your lives, the mustard seed, the hidden pearl, and celebrate, celebrate with joy God's presence in your life. God's presence, grace, and love seeks to bring life, freedom, and equity to our world, into our lives. And when we recognize God's presence, we experience a taste of divine blessing. And we recognize the ways in which God has endowed us with gifts and talents to further God's way. And with those gifts and talents, God invites us to use them in different ways, that we might be useful in God's way. And we embrace Jesus' attitudes, actions in our daily interactions, our values, our ethics, our decisions, our life decisions. We go out of our way to make others feel included, accepted, loved, and served. We refuse to do violence to or ignore the rights of others. We turn away from materialism and consumerism and live a simple life. And we want everyone to enjoy the benefits that we enjoy. We pray that there will be enough for all. And we practice mindfulness, choosing every moment to engage and interact and respond with the world that God created, the world that God loves so much, and all who inhabit this beautiful creation, just as Jesus did. And Jesus invites us to open our hearts, open our minds to the love of God, pointing us to God. are, when you do so in my name, if you don't do so with love and prayerful attention, you are making a difference. When you act with love and compassion and care for the one in need, in the community in need, you are making a difference. And I believe that Jesus' words today is so important for us to hear. Because day after day, we're hearing news of the effects of extreme weather conditions around the world. We see the images and pictures. And we're facing an existential crisis.
Yeah.